Hey YouTube, this is City Prepping. In this video, we're going to take a look at the new Ecoflow Delta Max. This is a very ambitious unit that packs a massive punch in a small package. But does it deliver? And even more importantly, is it a good fit for the emergency preparedness community? I'll try to answer this question and more. Here's what we'll cover in the video. What makes it unique compared to the other models on the market? Technical specifications of this unit. Testing the output capabilities. Can it handle a heavy load? Charging it with solar to simulate what you can expect if the grid were down. Use cases in an actual disaster situation. Will it power your needs after a disaster? Advantages of solar generators over gas generators. Should you build your own portable battery solar setup? And final thoughts. If at any time in this video you want to skip around, I'll put timestamps in the description and I'll add chapters to the progress bar below. Also, I'll put a link in the description section below if you'd like to check this unit out, as they are having a sale on these units at the time of the release of this video. So let's jump in. What makes this unit unique? I've reviewed a lot of various solar generators over the years, and they each have their own unique features, but this model has very notable features worth discussing up front. First, it's expandable. You can add two 2,000 watt hour batteries to this unit, bringing it to a total of 6,048 watt hours. These extra batteries connect to the side and charge and discharge in unison with the Delta Max. Next, the Delta Max has what's called extreme fast charge, which allows for rapid charging from 0 to 80% in just 65 minutes. If you prefer it not to charge so quickly when plugging it in a wall socket, if you're concerned you may flip your breaker, you can flip the switch on the back to reduce the charging speed. This brings me to my next point, the X-Boost feature. With this technology, you can control the discharge rate. While it's rated for 2400 watts continuous discharge, if you want to increase this, you can. This allows you to power devices that require 3400 watt max in total, while the rated output power remains 2400 watts. Just be careful not to use sensitive electrical devices if exceeding the 2400 watt limit. It also contains EPS, or emergency power supply capabilities. This means you can plug in the Delta Max and the Delta Mini into a wall socket and plug the devices you need to power into these units. It will provide power directly from the wall plug-in. But if the power goes out, the battery will kick in and provide power within 30 milliseconds. A UPS, on the other hand, will typically provide power within about 8 milliseconds. So this may not be an option for more sensitive devices like a data server or a workstation. For those on oxygen machines or other critical devices that need uptime, if the power were to go down, they could benefit from this feature. Another nice but not critical feature is the ability to connect to and control the device via an app. It does come in handy when you want to monitor, adjust settings, and update firmware via the app. Obviously, these devices charge from solar panels, which provide you an infinite source of power if there were a disaster as long as the sun is shining. We'll talk more about that momentarily. Technical specifications. This unit can output 2400 continuous watts with a pure sine wave, 3400 watts with X-Boost, and it can handle a whopping 5,000 watts of surge. The battery capacity is 2,000 watt hours. If you're not sure what any of this means, please see my video entitled How Much Power Will I Need to Survive, as it explains running, surge, and capacity in layman terms. I'll post a link to it in the cards above. Weight comes in at 48 pounds. The battery chemistry is lithium magnesium cobalt oxide, or MCM. While some solar generators use lithium iron phosphate batteries, such as the Ecoflow Delta Pro, this unit uses NCM battery chemistry, which supports 800 charge cycles to 80% capacity. I'll explain this more in a moment. On the back, we have solar charging input at 800 watts max via MC4 connector connected to an internal MPPT charger. It has a voltage range of 11 to 100 volts. You can also plug in a car charger here as well. AC charging speed option for fast or slow charging. This allows up to a whopping 1800 watt max at 15 amps. AC charging input port, overload protection switch, 6 AC outlets, 2 DC 5521 ports, 12 volt charging, and on the front, you've got 4 USB ports, 2 USB-C ports, a Wi-Fi connection, and an LCD display. On the side, you have a ventilation fan and extra battery ports. Putting it through the paces. So now that we've run through the specs, does this unit perform as advertised? The first test I'll show is running the Delta Max, powering 2400 watts continuously. For this test, I hooked up a few devices that collectively pull roughly 2400 watts. While powering them, the output on the front of the Delta Max shows a discharge rate. During testing, the discharge rate fluctuated between 2300 and 2500, with an average discharge of roughly 2400 watts. For this test, we get a fair depiction of how it will perform under load with various items. As advertised on their website, the Delta Max ran at 2400 watts continuously until the battery was depleted. One important thing to point out here, drawing power from lithium batteries at the max capacity that the manufacturer advertises does have an impact on the battery. If you were to buy a car and the engine redlines at 7,000 RPM, running the engine at this RPM all the time would shorten the life of the engine. Regardless of the manufacturer of these solar generators, it's not advised to run them at 100% all the time. Typically, it's recommended you run at about 60 to 70% of the possible output to keep from shortening the life of the battery. Plus, they give you the option for the X boost so you can bump that number up if you need more power. As shown here, I added another device to really up the output. They leave it up to the individual to decide how to use their device. Just something for you to consider when determining your power needs, an issue we'll address in a moment. Charging it with solar. Next, after depleting the batteries, I ran various tests charging both the main unit itself and the additional batteries with solar. The Delta Max can charge with 800 watts of panels. If you have the optional battery packs plugged in while the Delta Max charges, they will charge in unison, meaning they all go up together and charge. It's also worth noting that the Ecoflow is engineered to allow you to use other solar panels if you so choose to. As long as the solar panels use an MC4 connector and its voltage is between 11 to 100 volts and under 10 amps, you'll be fine. Shown here, I tested with three off-grid Trek 200 watt solar blankets tied together in series. These can easily be rolled up and stored away, making them very portable and compact. I've done a standalone video for this product if you want to check it out. I'll post a link in the cards and in the description section below. Having an option that is lightweight and compact that you can grab in an emergency and easily deploy it to charge your power station is an option. If you're interested in checking these out, I'll post a link in the description section to their website. As shown, I also tested the Delta Mini. It's a pint-sized powerhouse that packs a punch. This unit can accept 300 watts of solar panels and also works with other solar panels on the market. If you're looking for something with a little less output and capacity and want to save some money, it's definitely worth looking at. Use cases for this unit. After a disaster, having the ability to charge a device like this to provide power for critical devices would be beneficial. As Texas recently experienced during a snowstorm that knocked power offline, having the ability to run a small portable electric heater, power a DC electric blanket, boil water, or cook food on a hot plate would come in handy when there's no electricity or gas for your stoves or heater. What would you practically use this for in an emergency preparedness? If there were an emergency and the power were cut to your house, here are a few commonly used devices and how long it would power each off one charge. Smartphones, 125 charges. Laptop, 20 charges. Basecamp LED, 178 hours. CPAP machine, 20 hours. 7.1 cubic feet freezer, 32 hours. 20-foot cubic refrigerator freezer, about 19 hours. Ask yourself this question. If the power were to be shut off from my house for 3 days, maybe 1 week, maybe even a month, what would I need to power? This leads us to our next point. Will it power your needs after disaster? If you're not sure if this device will power your specific needs, again, I would refer you to my previous video, which I'll link to in the cards above and in the description section below, that goes into more detail to help you determine your exact power needs after a disaster and whether a device like this would work. If you want a summary, an easy way to make that decision is to first define what you would want to power if the power were to go out. Put the items in a spreadsheet and in one column, put the running watts, and in another column, write down their surge watts. If you're not sure what the values are, I'll provide a link to a wattage worksheet which will help. By defining this information in advance and adding it all up, it will help you understand what your power needs will be and whether this device will be a good fit for you. Remember, the Delta Max battery holds about 2,000 watt hours, so that means that if all the devices you need to power combined use 1,000 watts per hour, you'll deplete the battery in 2 hours unless you've got it hooked up to an external power source like solar panels. It's also worth noting that you can power devices from the Delta Max while charging it. In an emergency situation, I would charge this during the day with solar panels and power what I need during the daytime while I charge it. I would try to top this off before the end of the day to then power critical devices overnight. If you realize that the power this unit can provide is more than what you need, you can check out their Delta Mini. It can power bigger electronics with an output of 1400 watts. Like the Delta Max, though, it has many of the same features, such as X-Boost, EPS, and connects to an app for monitoring. If your budget is tight but you still want a solar generator, it is a powerful option that packs a considerable punch. advantage of solar generators over gas generators. Anytime I discuss these devices, the question always comes up, why not just buy a gas generator? Here are a few main considerations. Number one, OPSEC. OPSEC stands for operational security. If the power were to go down for a considerable amount of time, there is a good chance that by running a gas generator, you'll gain unwanted attention. Between the noise and fumes, others will know that you have power and that you're prepared. Desperation causes people to do things they wouldn't do otherwise. Number two, unlimited supply of power. When running carbon-based generators such as gas or propane, you're limited to how much fuel you can store. Once that fuel supply runs out, then the power goes out. With a solar generator, on the other hand, as long as you've got sun, you can charge these devices. In addition, you can still power your devices while it's charging from the solar panels. Or, of course, you can connect a small motor to a hamster wheel that may be able to harvest the power through this option. But I digress. Number three, no maintenance. While solar generators technically don't require maintenance, I do charge them and discharge them on a monthly basis. Letting a lithium battery discharge to a lower percentage and then sit in storage will damage the battery. And that's about the extent of maintenance. Gas generators, on the other hand, are machines with moving parts and require oil changes, spark plug replacements, and monitoring the gas to make sure it doesn't get old. Between the two options, you've got less work to consider with a solar generator. Should you build your own? When doing these types of videos, a question inevitably comes up, why not just build one of my own? Why spend money on something like this when I could build it for cheaper? The short answer is, yeah, go for it. I plan on doing a video in the future showing how to make your own battery backup system. But let's make a few things clear. If you're planning on building something this small and portable, with the internal electronics and capable of something like this, unless you're a full-time engineer with a team that can manufacture this, good luck. I had this exact conversation on a prepper subreddit a few years ago, where an individual came across a video detailing making a solar generator comparable to the Energy Kodiak. He learned the hard way how difficult it was, and the cost and time he incurred was, well, not cheap. Now, the counter-argument could be made that he learned a lot through the process, and I would agree. While I researched an extra year on building a battery system that can charge from solar or wind, I have no illusion that I could build something this compact and well-engineered. I could probably build something as powerful, but not as quite as intelligent or portable as this. Having said that, if you want something like this to ensure you have power after a disaster, and you have neither the time nor the skills to build it yourself, well, that should answer your question. Again, I plan on releasing a video sometime early next year, building a more permanent home-based backup battery system that charges off wind or solar. Hopefully this video gave you enough information regarding technical specifications, actual use cases, and gives you an example of how it performs under certain loads as I ran through the different tests, and I show that in the video. Now let's get down to brass tacks. What do I really think about this? Who is this for? Who would I not recommend this for? So let's start off with what my thoughts are on this unit. I've tested a lot of these units over the years. I've had a lot sent to me recently. I'm gonna be doing quite a lot of videos on these over the next 2 months. And I'm gonna do one large video in January showing pretty much the five main manufacturers that have comparable units and what I think about each and which one stands out. I will say that this unit, for the size and the range, you know, the 1500 to 2000 watt hour range and output capability, which there are several models on the market like this, I would have to say it's probably at this moment one of my top go-to units that I would recommend to subscribers. It's built like a tank. It's expandable. I like that Ecoflow is doing a lot of innovation. They've got a lot of other products they have on the market that they're rolling out. They seem to be really getting out there and doing innovation, where some of the companies I've been working with are getting a little behind, but some I've talked to, they're going to be catching up next year. All that to say, it's something I'm comfortable recommending to people, and quite honestly, I do keep it next to my bug out gear. If there's a disaster, it's probably the unit I'm going to grab to take, along with either some solar blankets or the solar panel, depending on how much space I have that the company sent me. Now, who is it not for? I would say anybody that's kind of getting into a permanent situation where they're going to be going through a lot of charges and they want this unit to last for a long time, maybe like an off-grid homestead or a cabin, you're going to probably want to look for something with lithium iron phosphate batteries. Now, Ecoflow, they do have the Delta Pro, and I'll be reviewing that one next month. It's much larger, and that one is lithium iron phosphate. But there are other options on the market in the comparable size that are lithium iron phosphate. The downside, of course, with that battery is it's way heavier. The charge cycles, though, it's about 4 to 5 times as many charges that you'll get before the battery starts losing its ability to hold or its capacity starts dropping. All that to say, If you want something that you can move with quickly, that is small, I love the fact that they were able to put so much in a compact unit and it's portable. I would highly recommend this unit. I have no qualms recommending it to anybody. Again, through my testing, playing around with it, it performed just the way the specs online suggest or say they do. So there was no surprises. All that to say, again, if you're in the market and you're kind of on the fence and not sure, should you buy, should you wait till you see all the options? Again, I'll be doing a review next month and I don't fault you, but overall, it's something I'm comfortable recommending. Now, if you need something that can expand way past the capacity, because that one can go up to 6 kilowatt hours in total. Again, there are other options on the market, one in particular that can go past that. So if you have any questions, any concerns, any feedback, feel free to post that below or even shoot me an email and I'll try to do my best to answer those questions. But again, if you're interested and you're in the market, I'll post a link in the description section below. Again, I feel comfortable recommending it. I would to my friends or family. And it's something, again, I keep next to my bug out gear for the purpose of having an option that we can quickly charge. Again, that's one of the other features I love, that it can quickly charge up, that it has that, the extreme capability that you can charge it very fast. A lot of unique features about this model. So again, please let me know if you have any questions or concerns. And as always, stay safe out there.